I recently had the pleasure of editing one of the episodes from the Embody podcast, which was an interview with Ken Honda, who recently published the book Happy Money. Ken Honda is an incredible author from Japan, and he has brought out a whole bunch of books. I think it's nearing almost 100 or something like that. And in this book specifically, he brings a lot of the wisdom that he has gathered over the years into the English language, which is quite interesting to kind of like put all of the learnings that he has together with all the Western learnings or the other money books that are out there. Some of the books in that kind of realm that I read in the past could be Rich Dad, Poor Dad, as well as Money Master of the Game, which is by Tony Robbins. Now, this book is a lot different than those books, because from what I remember about those books, they are mostly about the tactics around certain money things. And also specifically Money Master of the Game, it is mostly about investing and future-proofing yourself, going in index funds and stuff like that. Now, I don't really have all the truths in the sense of money. I'm myself still very much figuring this life out. I'm still figuring out the income game, where to get money from, as well as where to send it to, how to invest and stuff like that. I'm not a self-made millionaire by any means at this point in time. However, I would like to present some of the learnings that I gathered throughout reading the book from Ken Honda, The Happy Money. And overall, I have to say, this book really caught me in some interesting moment where it's rethinking a lot of the beliefs that are around money. And it helps me to exactly do that by kind of like bringing certain stories, explaining certain aspects that are maybe hard to grasp when you don't really have the environment for it and stuff like that. So I am on this journey probably as much as you are, trying to figure out what to do with my money, how to earn it, how to treat it, and all these kind of things. And now I just want to give you a little bit of a list of aspects and ideas that I took away after having read the Happy Money book. And yeah, let's go into it. The first one that comes to mind is letting go of expectations around pretty much everything. This is something that I've gathered in many different aspects, many different ways of life. And with money, that is just one more aspect where we should let go of expectations. Because if you expect someone to pay you, if you expect certain money to come in and all that kind of stuff, you're building up for failure. Because if that doesn't work out, then you're screwed. However, if you just try to, and that's obviously one of the biggest struggles of all, stay in the moment and stay with what is here right now, you're setting yourself up for a more content life. And with this, it's the same thing. So letting go of expectations around money, around people, what you want from them, what you think they should give you or stuff like that, letting go of that probably frees you a lot more to actually do what you want to be doing and do what feels good. Because if you, for example, figure out, well, if I always give more than I receive, maybe you should stop giving as much. And the other thing, if you love to give and you love the reactions of something, that's a great place to spend your energy and bring more of that inspired action, so to speak. One thing that kind of goes in hand with that is also to shift your beliefs around money. And that is specifically talking also about the aspects of shifting your ancestral beliefs or what you gathered from grandparents, from your parents, from your societal background, from your community around you, shifting away from beliefs that were instilled into you or you also gathered up and you took them in as truths. And maybe those are not really truths after all. And I'm going to talk about some of those that I found quite interesting just reading this book and hearing a couple of the accounts that Ken shares with us. One of those accounts that was really interesting was to realize that everybody has some sort of money struggle, or at least most people do, unless they are, as Ken says, in the happy money flow. Pretty much anyone has struggles, whether they have a lot of money or they don't have enough money. And he talks a lot about the situation where it's very easy to believe that other people have it better than you because they have a lot of money. However, he also describes a couple of instances where he tried to figure out when does someone who financially is very well off find themselves to be actually well off. And the interesting thing was that when he asked a millionaire with a private jet, he asked, well, are you well off? And the person actually answered, no, because my private jet is smaller than the other person's private jet. So even though this person probably could live until their end of the life, just by the money that they already have, they still weren't well off in their own image. Now, it is to be said that this struggle to not have the bigger airplane compared to someone else might be kind of like ridiculous for someone who's struggling to put food on the table. However, if you actually look at the person in the context of their situation, they might actually feel worse because of that. So, of course, it's easy to say, like, well, that's tough, right? Like, having a smaller plane than someone else is really tough. But at the end of the day, those people are struggling inside of themselves. And someone who has little money but is completely content with their life might actually be much happier than the person that has all that money. Another example is also that he describes people that fear losing all the money that they amassed. So, for example, if someone cracks 1 million in net worth or something like that, and then they adjust their lifestyle to that spending, and then at some point they start fearing that the money might not be there tomorrow. There might be a financial crash, there might be some other circumstances that take away all that money, or they might get screwed over or something like that. So the fear of losing all that money for someone who has a lot might actually be worse than for someone who just knows the money is coming in and then I'm going to spend it. And it's just in that flow, and I trust in that flow, and I'm happy with my money, which is going to be another aspect of this list. Ken also talks about loving what you do as well as living your best life. And this actually funneled into an aspect that shook me to the core in a sense when I read it. And that saying, or that idea that he shared, was it may actually take you 10, 15 years to find what you actually want to be doing. However, once you did find that thing that is inspiring for you, that is your passion, and you actually stepped forward to take responsibility and make that happen, that thing that is the calling in a sense for you, then everything else will take its course more or less by itself, and success can be very quick, or your lifestyle shifts might adjust in a way that all of a sudden everything is much, much easier around you. So however long you are already on your journey, just know that with your own development and your own growth and your own shifts that you are experiencing inside of you, you are getting stronger to represent yourself. You're going on that path toward more of being you as yourself. That is something that will eventually also help you on that path to be more in the flow of money and also in the flow of happy money. And the last point that I want to touch on is also one of the bigger points that Ken always shares, and he shared it in the podcast that's going to be on the Embody podcast, which I will link down in the description. However, that's going to be published sometime in September. So when you go to that link, you will find it there. You can subscribe to the podcast of Candice. It's really incredible conversations every time. And in this case, they talked about the topic of arigato in and arigato out in terms of saying thank you to your money when it comes in, as well as thanking your money when you're sending it out into the world again. And this is really a aspect that I immediately tried to take into my own life. And when I last was in Berlin, for example, and did my 3-day fast, that already was something that I felt into when I went to this restaurant and I ate something for the first time after 3 days. And then saying thank you to your money when you actually pay the waiter. And you're not only giving away that money, giving it away into the flow of money again, but also, you can think about it in a way that you are actually paying for someone's food on the table. You're actually paying for someone's rent by doing that. So you are supporting someone else. And the same thing goes for when you earn your money. So saying thank you to the person that is actually paying you, saying being grateful for the opportunity that you had to actually earn that money, for the skills that you have that gave you that opportunity to even do that kind of work, or for the gift that you're receiving from a relative or something like that. Always bringing that back to gratitude and saying thank you, no matter what you are paying for, no matter what bills you are paying, and stuff like that. Just always keeping in mind that this flow of money is helping you, you are helping others, and even if it's taxes, because at the end of the day, even those are something that hold up a structural system in which you are being born into or in which you are living. And that's really something to be grateful for and celebrate. So arigato in and arigato out, whenever you spend your money, whenever you earn your money, to also shift your beliefs around it. And with all of those shifts that we can incorporate into our life, into our experience around money. And it's really interesting how Ken shares all of these pieces of wisdom with stories about his relatives, with stories about his own family, as well as clients and other storylines that he has encountered over the last couple of years, and built all that information together to now share it in this book. So with that said, I want to send you out into the world again. I'm grateful that you are here. I'm grateful for the opportunity that I have to even be on this YouTube channel, have the ability to share what I'm learning, what I'm discovering here. And I will have the link to the book on Amazon in the description below. And I will also have the link to the podcast episode for when it comes out on the Embody podcast in the description below as well. And with all of that being said, I hope you have an incredible day, and I will see you soon in another video. Ciao, ciao.